Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we're gonna be talking about the Amex Trifecta credit card setup and whether or not it's worth it. Now, I recently just got the Amex Blue Business Plus to complete my own Amex Trifecta setup to go along with the Amex Platinum card and the Amex Gold card. But I wanna go over some of my thoughts on this credit card setup in this video, because while it'll be earning me a ton of membership rewards points along with some extra credits and other benefits, it's going to cost me $945 per year to do so. So make sure to go ahead and drop a like down below and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, but let's get right into it here. Now, getting my Amex Trifecta into place has been something that I've been slowly working on over the past year, and it's been just a little bit over 1 year to the day since I got my Amex Gold card, which was the first card that I got in this setup. And the reason why I chose the Amex Gold card for the first card in this Amex setup was because back in November of 2020, I had already gotten my Chase Trifecta into place and I was looking at where to go next. I was looking for a credit card that would allow me to earn a good amount of points across different food related categories, including groceries, because while it might not show on camera, I'm about 6'4" and I spend much more than the average person does on groceries. The Amex Gold seemed like a great choice because it gets 4x membership rewards points on groceries, 4x membership rewards points on dining at restaurants, as well as 3x points on flights. I'm not gonna lie, the $250 annual fee did make me a little bit hesitant at first when looking to apply for the Gold card, but knowing that there was also a $120 Uber credit and a $120 dining credit helped me to feel a lot better, because at the beginning of 2021, I knew that I was going to be soon moving to a new area with a lot of great restaurants and places to go out to eat, and I was going to be able to get good value from the credits that go along with the Gold card through Uber Eats and Grubhub and things like that. Now, when I signed up for the Amex Gold card, I was able to lock in a welcome bonus offer of 60,000 membership rewards points after spending, I believe, $4,000 in the first 6 months of having this card. Of course, if I had just waited a little bit longer, a few more months, I would have been able to get a much higher welcome bonus for 75,000 membership rewards points, which is a welcome bonus offer that's been floating around for a few months lately. But overall, as I've said in previous videos, I think that the Amex Gold card is going to be a great option for many people out there because of the way that it focuses very heavily on food related categories and the way that it earns points and the credits that come along with this card. And of course, food related spending categories are going to be one of those areas of spending that no one out there can avoid. Now, about 3 months after getting the Amex Gold, I saw an offer out there for the Amex Platinum card where I could get 100,000 MR points after spending $5,000 on the card in the first 6 months. So that welcome bonus was great, and I believe one of the highest offered on the Amex Platinum at that time. But of course, now they've increased that welcome bonus offer to 125,000 points. And that's sort of one thing that I've learned with credit card welcome bonuses, is that they come in cycles, and it's really tough to time exactly which welcome bonus offer out there is going to be the best one and the highest one for you. But on top of getting 100,000 points as my welcome bonus, I was also eligible to get 10x points at US grocery stores and US gas stations for the first 6 months of having this card. And again, I spend a ton at grocery stores and a little bit here and there at gas stations, so I knew that I could earn a lot of points with this overall welcome bonus offer, so I decided to apply. I know that I just said 3 months prior to getting approved for this Amex Platinum card that I was going to be using my new Amex Gold as my dedicated go-to grocery store card, but to be honest, 10x back at grocery stores with the Platinum card versus 4x back on the Gold card was just too good to pass up for the next 6 months. Plus, I knew that there were credits on the Amex Gold to help offset the annual fee, so I was okay with making this decision. Now, my original plan with the Platinum card was to get the Charles Schwab version of the Amex Platinum, because that version is going to allow me to transfer my MR points, if I want to, into a Charles Schwab brokerage account at a value of 1.1 cents per point, where I could then use that money to invest it however I want to. What I like to do is conservatively value my membership rewards points at 1 cent per point as they sit inside my American Express account. And then as I go to transfer them out to different travel partners, I try to get closer to 1.5 cents per point or higher as I go to book things like flights or hotels. But if I'm not traveling for a while, or if I'm not seeing many good redemption options for my points for the places that I'm traveling to, then what I like to do is not let my points sit in my account for too long, because if they just sit there, then it's kind of like cash sitting in a bank account where it's losing its value thanks to things like inflation. So the Schwab Platinum is a great option because it's gonna give me a redemption option that's greater than 1 cent per point at 1.1 cents per point for those MR points as I transfer them into my Schwab brokerage account. And then I could do whatever I want with those proceeds and turn that into an investment that can grow over time. But I had a plan with the regular vanilla Platinum card. I wanted to apply for this card, get the high welcome bonus, and then use it for the next 6 months to earn 10x back on groceries and gas stations. And then I can evaluate my plans for keeping or canceling buying this card in February of 2022. Now, when I got this card, I had no idea that rumors would soon surface about American Express adding new credits to the card and increasing the annual fee. But sure enough, earlier this year in the summer of 2021, American Express bumped the annual fee from $550 per year to $695 per year. So what I'm gonna do when my Platinum card comes up for renewal in February of 2022 is I'm gonna call up American Express. I'm gonna explain to them that when I applied for this card earlier in 2021, I had not anticipated an increase to the annual fee, and see if that helps them to offer me some sort of retention offer. That way I can get some bonus membership rewards points. If I get a retention offer for some more points, then great, I'll just keep the card open for another year. If not, I'll probably decide to close the card and then in the near future, get the Schwab version of the Amex Platinum. That way I have that 1.1 cents per point redemption option. Now, personally, I know that I do get a lot of value out of the different credits and benefits that come along with the Amex Platinum card, but I know many others out there don't feel the same way, and they kind of feel like it's hard to use all these different things that are offered with the Platinum card just to offset that $695 annual fee. I specifically get a lot of value out of the Uber credit, the airline incidental fee credit, the digital entertainment credit with Audible, as well as the Saks Fifth Avenue credit. And I talk about a few tricks that I use to get the most out of that Saks Fifth Avenue credit in another video that I made. So I'll put that video on the screen right now, and I definitely recommend that you check that out if you're interested. So I'll still be happy having some version of the Amex Platinum. I just wanna make sure that the timing is right when I do decide to eventually close out that regular vanilla version of the Platinum card and then go for the Schwab version. And I'll also be eligible for the welcome bonus on the Schwab version, which is really, really nice too. Okay, so now with those two American Express cards in my wallet, I had a solid foundation set to create an Amex Trifecta setup, and all I needed to complete that setup was going to be the Amex Blue Business Plus. Now, I was in no rush to get this card because, number one, I had just gotten the Amex Platinum, and for the next 6 months, all of my grocery store spending and all my gas station spending was going to go on that card, so I really didn't want to have to be working on a minimum spend requirement to get a welcome bonus on another card at the same time. And number two, the Blue Business Plus is a business credit card, and I was really just getting my business started throughout 2021. The Blue Business Plus was going to be my catch-all card for miscellaneous expenses in this Amex Trifecta setup because it gets 2x membership rewards points on all purchases. And recently, I finally felt like the timing was right to apply for and get approved for the Blue Business Plus, so now I had my completed Amex Trifecta setup, and next in this video, I want to talk a little bit about my plans for the Amex Trifecta in 2022 and whether or not the $945 annual fee of this credit card setup is worth it. Now, with the Blue Business Plus, I now have 9 credit cards, which, to be honest, is a lot for me to keep track of. Normally, I would just manage all the cards in my head or on a spreadsheet, but as I've recently started increasing these number of cards, I knew that I needed to get more organized. So what I've been using lately is an app called Max Rewards, and many of you may already be familiar with this app, but it's something that I've been using to keep track of all my credit cards. All I simply do is link all of my credit card accounts on the app on my phone, and what it does is it'll show me all the different balances across my different cards. It'll show me when my bills are due, my credit utilization, and a bunch of other things like that. But what I really like about the app is that it also keeps track of rewards for me too. So if I have a minimum spend requirement that I'm working on to get a new welcome bonus, it'll show me exactly how much I have left to spend on a new credit card to get the welcome bonus. It'll help keep track of my rewards balances across Chase, American Express, and any other issuer that I have. It also shows me what card to use at different local stores and restaurants and other places like that to get the best return on spend across my 9 different credit cards. I also like using Max Rewards Gold, which is the paid version of their app, and this allows me to have my different Chase and Amex offers and bonus quarterly categories automatically activated for me, allowing me to easily get more value out of my different credit cards. Now, if you guys want to check out Max Rewards, then you can use my link that I'll have down in the description below, where most of these features that I mentioned come with the free version of the app. But if you do want to try out Max Rewards Gold to get all the features included, you could use my code DBRAWN to get 1 free month. So now that my Amex Trifecta is complete and my credit cards are organized, I've been using the Amex Trifecta alongside my Chase Trifecta to really maximize all that I can get out of my credit cards, because I think both of these credit card setups really can complement each other pretty well. If you watched my most recent video about what's in my wallet for the winter of 2021, you'll know that there's 4 credit cards that I'm currently carrying with me right now. 2 Chase credit cards, which are the Freedom Unlimited and the Freedom Flex, and then 2 American American Express cards, which are the Amex Gold and the Blue Business Plus. And like I explained in that video, I pretty much value American Express membership rewards points and Chase Ultimate rewards points as essentially being equal. So all I'm doing is just using whatever card is going to give me the best return in the different categories that I'm spending in. I'm using the Freedom Flex for my grocery spending because it's getting me 9x back on groceries for the rest of the fourth quarter of 2021, which is greater than the 4x membership rewards points that I'm getting with the Amex Gold card. But I'm using the Amex Gold for dining at restaurants because it's getting 4x points there compared to only 3x points on different Chase cards that I have. So that's my approach to using the Amex Trifecta alongside the Chase Trifecta at the moment. But let's get to the final part of the video that I want to talk about here, and that is the Amex Trifecta worth it? Well, like I've mentioned in many of my other previous videos about the Amex Platinum and the Amex Gold, these two cards are really not going to be worth it for everyone out there. I personally have always recommended the Chase Trifecta to most people out there because those points are very easy to redeem in many different ways to still get good value, especially if you're redeeming for things like travel. But the Amex Trifecta is going to be worth it for you if a few of the following things apply to you. First of all, if you know that you're going to be able to get good value out of the many different credits that are combined across both the Amex Platinum and the Amex Gold card, then the Amex Trifecta is going to be worth it. But be careful because many of these credits are easy to forget to use, so make sure that you fully understand what goes into using all these credits. And you can check out some other videos that I have here on this channel where I explain these credit cards and these credits in much more detail. Second thing to consider when deciding if the Amex Trifecta is worth it is, do you want to be paying all these high annual fees? No matter how much value you're able to get out of the different benefits and credits that are offered on all these credit cards in the Amex Trifecta setup, spending $945 combined in annual fees across these three cards is not a cheap price, and there's many other no annual fee cards out there that can offer similar cash back earning rates to these cards. And third, do you plan to use your membership rewards points to redeem for travel through American Express's travel partners? American Express is notorious for having very bad cash redemption values for their membership rewards points outside of having that 1.1 cents per point option with the Schwab Platinum. If you have the regular Platinum or the Gold card or the Blue Business Plus, then redeeming your MR points for cash as a statement credit is only going to get you 0.6 cents per point, which is just terrible compared to the fact that Chase and their Ultimate Rewards points is going to give you a value of 1 cent per point when redeeming those points for a statement credit. But if you can learn how to redeem your membership rewards points with one of American Express's many great travel partners, then you can really increase the amount of redemption value you get for those points, and then it makes the Amex Trifecta much more appealing and much more worth it. So for all those reasons, if I could sum it up in one sentence for who the Amex Trifecta is worth it for, if you're someone that travels frequently and you're able to get good value out of the different credits and benefits offered by the different cards in the setup, then the Amex Trifecta is worth it. If you don't travel frequently, but you still do manage to get good value out of the different credits and benefits from the Amex Trifecta, then I would recommend that you swap in the Schwab version of the Platinum card because that's gonna give you that 1.1 cents per point redemption option that acts as a floor value right there and still lets you get a lot out of your membership rewards points. Well, that wraps it up for this video. Make sure to go ahead and subscribe down below because I do plan on making many more videos in the near future about a few different redemptions that I have planned for different trips that I have upcoming. So I'm gonna be filming different ways that I redeem both my membership rewards points and my Ultimate Rewards points across American Express and Chase. So be sure to tune in for that. And if you wanna learn more about some of the cards that I talked about here in this video, then go check out this video over here that I made about the Chase Trifecta, which is the rival to the Amex Trifecta. Or go check out this video over here where I compare one card from each setup, comparing both the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Amex Gold card. As always, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.